America in the 1960s was filled with optimism and economic development, along with the rise of media and the need for freedom of the youth. Out of this new popular culture, pop art was born and became a hallmark of this turbulent decade. In this video, we'll give you some information to know what pop art is and how it contributed to American society and culture at this time. One of the pioneers of this art movement, pop art is popular, transient, expandable, low cost, mass produced, young, witty, sexy, gimmicky, glamorous, and big business. Pop art emerged in Britain in the mid-1950s. The independent group founded in London in 1952 is regarded as the precursor to the pop art movement. They were a gathering of young artists who challenged prevailing modernist approaches to culture, as well as traditional views of fine art. Meanwhile, in America, pop art was officially introduced in December 1962 and became popular during the 1960s, the time when American artists had to search deeper for dramatic styles that would distance art from the well-designed and clever commercial materials. Pop art was strongly influenced by Dadaism, a school of thought which rejected traditional social constructs and represented a tidal shift away from logic and reason through art. It was also widely interpreted as a reaction to the dense, serious, and highbrow artworks of abstract expressionism, a popular art movement in the post-World War II period, emphasized on spontaneous, automatic, or subconscious creation. The materials for pop art came from many aspects of mass culture, such as advertising, comic books, and celebrities. Using popular images, pop art rebelled against the traditional views on art and culture by highlighting the banal or kitschy element of any culture, often through the use of irony. Pop art in America was best presented in paintings, sculptures, fashion, and music. In paintings, colors were usually bright and vivid to refer to popular culture, the predominant colors being yellow, red, and blue. Other features of pop art artworks were clear lines, sharp paintwork, and clear representations of symbols, people, and objects. Sculpture of this movement took commonplace objects like spoon, ice cream, or toilet, and created them as sculptures on a massive scale, inserting them into ordinary landscapes to call attention to stated of everyday things. In fashion field, pop artists introduced a bright palette of colors and print definition form to many designers at that time and onwards. Moreover, fashion at this time evolved toward a more enjoyable, wearable, and affordable manner. Andy Warhol's super dress, the one featuring Campbell's soup cans, is the best example. Also, Yves Saint Laurent collection in 1966 openly referred to this art revolution, proving that fashion is best enjoyed when you can have a little fun with it. Pop art contributed to music by influencing a new style of pop music called art pop, started in the mid-1960s. Pop art did have a great contribution in American society and culture in the 1960s. First, in terms of social impact, pop art is believed to hold the mirror up to American society by reflecting its social context and values. Due to pop art's presence, the picture of American society in the 1960s was exhibited very clearly. The years following World War II saw an enormous growth in American economy, which led to the innovations in technology and media. As a result, the manufacturing industry began to spawn the consumerism in America, a consumer culture with more leisure time and expendable income than ever before. At the same time, a revolt in mindset of American young artists against the traditional perspective of what art should be was provoked. They felt that what they were taught at art school and what they saw in the museum did not reflect their exact society. Therefore, they turned to sources such as Hollywood movies, advertising, product packaging, pop music, and comic books for their imagery. Under the circumstances, the necessity of developing a new style of art must arise. Second, in terms of cultural effect, pop art might be considered as one of the most popular style of art, which succeeded in getting through the general public in a way that few modern art movements did or have done since. It was an instrument to open up the world of painting and sculpture to ordinary people who, perhaps for the first time in their lives, could instantly recognize and appreciate the exhibits in front of them. But they were far less likely to feel intimidated by an everyday image they could relate to. In this sense, pop art made museums and galleries more relevant to the general public. It created a more inclusive and more relevant style of art, and more importantly, benefited in enriching American culture. Pop art was depicted to be the first movement to progress into the American contemporary art era that emerged in the following decades. In conclusion, pop art was a glorious mark in America in the 60s. To acknowledge its role, Jim Dye, a famous American pop artist, once said, "Pop is everything art hasn't been for the last two decades. It's basically a U-turn back to a representational visual communication, moving at a breakaway speed. Pop is a re-enlistment in the world. It is the American dream, optimistic, generous, and naive."